Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Art for Peace Award YouTube channel. Today, my subject is how a person can heal from severe pain, and what can they do with faith? What can they do by listening to the inner voice? I'm going to introduce you with Anna Maria. Anna Maria,
good morning.
Tell us about your disease that you have, the disorder or a malfunction in your system.
I have what they call reflex sympathetic dystrophy, also known as complex regional pain syndrome. Mm-hmm. It's a misfiring of your nervous system. It's a very painful disease. It can start by a simple pinprick to your finger, to a heart attack, to any kind of trauma. I did sustain it from hitting my knee on my desk at work. I've had it for 22 years. Mm-hmm. Very, very painful. They put it way above cancer even.
Tell us everything that you have gone through.
I have gone through spinal cord stims, morphine pumps, many injections, years of doctors telling me I was crazy, being put on numerous narcotics that have done nothing but damage my body. You know, at the time they say, oh, they're the safest drug you could take. And then 10 years later, you find out, oh, well, this causes liver problems. It makes your teeth fall out. It does this, it does that. Mm-hmm. So where I'm at today, 22 years later, just about to the date, I am not on any narcotics. I am on vitamins and supplements. I am on my Bible, and I maintain my pain with taking a lot of hot baths. I still do have the pain. It's not as severe because I have learned to deal with it. I have learned to work through the pain. And I can honestly say I'm drug free.
Also, you told me something the doctors have to check your heart because they thought she was crazy and she's in severe pain.
Right? Well, no, what happened is 4 years ago or 5 years ago, I'm not quite sure how long ago it was, I was having surges of my blood pressure going up and down very quickly. Mm-hmm. It would rise and go down and then my heart rate would accelerate. And I went to several doctors, and of course they said, no, you're just having panic attacks, this and that. Finally, I was taken by an ambulance to the hospital. Didn't think I was gonna make it there that day. And the doctor told me what it was. It's from the reflex sympathetic dystrophy. My nerves were attacking my heart. Mm. So for about a month straight, I was 3-4 times a day in an ambulance to the hospital.
Wow.
And they would stop and restart my heart on the way there. They finally did a catheter ablation on me, and I have had really no problems since then. But no medication. I was on Dilaudid. I am not on anything now. No blood pressure medicine, nothing. Mm-hmm. The Lord has saved me and taught me how to work with my own body.
So tell us, what are you taking right now?
I am just taking vitamin D, mm-hmm. a high dose of it for the inflammation. Mm-hmm. I take flaxseed, cumin, cinnamon, the normal supplements basically that you take. And they are all basically for inflammation. So that's mm-hmm. stopping it.
So that stopped her pain.
Uh-huh. But and all the medicine did when they were prescribing medicines, I was prescribed Neurontin, Dilaudid, Tramadol, I can't even think, Prozac, all of them, trying to calm your wow. nerves down and things. All it is a Band-Aid on something that needs stitches.
A Band-Aid.
You know, it's like being a drug addict or an alcoholic. You know, when you're drinking or you're high, you feel great. But when it wears off, you got the pain again. Uh-huh. So it's not a cure. Mm-hmm. It's a cover-up.
Yeah.
And I have basically learned to cure my own body through prayer and supplements.
Learn to cure your own body, because your body is talking to you through the whole time, right? So you have to listen to your heart and develop your own energy and heal our own bodies, because no one is going to know what's going on. You can tell me what's going on, but I really don't know that pain.
You know, it's kind of like having a gynecologist that's a male. And or an OB, I should say, and you're in labor, and he's saying, calm down, you're okay. Oh no, you don't know what this feels like. You know that as a mother. A man cannot tell you how your body feels.
Yeah.
And nobody can tell you how your body feels.
Exactly. Because you have not gone through that pain.
No, you have not. And people I have known that have not had it will sit there and say, oh, it can't be that bad. The pain's not that bad. Mm-hmm. And I've known a couple of people that do have it now, and they go, I cannot believe what the pain is like.
So you know some people have the same issue.
I know quite a few.
You think it's been accelerated over the years than before? You see more of that? I have not seen any patient that's you.
People, I think the thing is more doctors are aware of the condition. Mm-hmm. When I first developed it, not many doctors knew. Mm-hmm. I mean, I went from doctor to doctor, and they all said it was in my head. I was crazy. And finally, I found one doctor. Mm-hmm. And then I have been working. Then the doctor that really started helping me a lot was a doctor over at UCLA.
What's his name?
Dr. Joshua Prager.
Okay, you know you can look for Dr. Joshua then.
Yes, he is director of pain management at UCLA. Fantastic doctor. He really helped me. And Dr. Seinel over at S&B Surgery Center.
So they,
they were great doctors, yes.
Okay. So at this current moment, she has managing her life, living a normal life. Because at first I remember she could barely move. She was shaking a lot.
I couldn't wear shoes at all for years. Yeah. I can wear shoes now. My feet would act up. The nerves would just go crazy. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of things still I'm not 100% back to, but I have acknowledged that. Mm-hmm. Weather conditions bother me. Mm-hmm. I do not like the cold weather. My nerves start acting up. Change of weather. Like out in the Inland Empire, you know, it could be 105 during the day and then it drops to 60 at night. That bothers me. A great change in temperature at a fast time. Going through the grocery stores and hearing the humming from the freezers bother. Or somebody pulls up next to you in a car and they've got the boom box going and the beep going.
Ah.
That will bother me.
Okay.
Anything that will set the
nerves
off.
So because it's related to nerves.
Right.
So any little tiny bitty thing is stimulating the nerves endings. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And any surgeries or any time I get injured, I have a chance of.
So this is, I think it's connected, it's called tactile corpuscles?
No.
The nerves endings that we have.
It's my nerve, it's like shingles, but inside my body.
Okay.
I mean, that's the easiest way I could describe it for someone that wouldn't understand what it is. Shingles, it's almost the same as neuropathy. Neuropathy is your neuropathic nervous system. Uh-huh. Mine are my other nervous systems.
Okay.
That involved. So it's just, it's a very complex situation, but your body's complex.
Mm-hmm.
Your body is very complex.
Yes.
And you need to be in tune with it and you need to realize what it is.
That's why I think it's worth spending time here so you know what's going on. Like with me, and I know how it feels to be feeling warm, energetic. So when you have the wrong foods, you can just feel your body. Hey, you gave me the wrong
Correct.
Food. You better give me a good food, you know. Yesterday in Santa Barbara, I had Paula's pancake. Ah! Okay, but my body didn't have, something was missing, you know. So I came home and I made some green smoothie and I had it feel better. So you have to listen to it because my body is so used to nutrition. But if I want to have junk, I can have junk. It's just like one meal is not going to kill me. It's just one meal is not going to make you healthy. Just a lifestyle. So it's okay if you like something, if you enjoy it, it's fine. Because those are special pancakes.
In moderation.
Definitely moderation.
In moderation.
I've never overeaten in my entire life. Never.
And I think also, as far as with me, going on more of a protein diet, not your normal protein, I still have my carbs and stuff, but a balanced diet, but a lot of greens and a lot of proteins has helped also.
That's right. It's a total lifestyle.
With the pain. Right, with the pain. And you get used to things, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But people need to realize when you have RSD, do not sit on a couch. Do not lay in that bed. Get up and move. Because if you don't move, you're going to lose it.
That's right. You can do 20 minutes exercise I have. That will help you develop your chi. That will help you get your circulation going. I have 3-4 exercises ready for you. So stay tuned. And thank you so much, Marian.
Thank you
so much. And I'm here in Ventura. Beautiful sea right there. watching. I'm here to share with you because I never met anybody like her. So she was the first one. I thought I'll share with you. So if you have the same symptom or someone else have it, you know what to do. And you're most welcome to call me. I'll connect you with her. She can lead you there. So my heart to your heart, love and peace. We have one. Mwah.